You just hear this. And you know you're in West Side Story.
Familiar with West Side Story?
West Side Story was absolutely groundbreaking.
The greatest challenge for any artist, then and even now.
It really has infiltrated pop culture in a way few musicals ever do.
It speaks to so many cultures and generations.
It's romance, it's passion, it's innocence that is not innocent anymore. It's mistakes that are made that are tragic.
West Side was unique. It just showed you possibilities.
The first time I saw West Side Story in Japan in 1969, I was there with Kirov Ballet, Russian company, a small cinema, a few people. That was a quite shocker to see such a profound, powerful, and utterly arresting piece of art. That was, for me, a kind of true Americana. You know, we were bombarded by political cartoons about America, you know, this fat people with cigars and dragging, you know, huge sacks of money. This film was not about that. It's a film about street people who had their own claims, how they see this country.
I say this turf is small, but it's all we got, huh?
And their conflicts are Shakespearean tragedy, of course.
I'm not one of them, Maria.
But you are not one of us.
I don't think I moved for like 15 minutes after the movie was over because it was like my life had been changed forever. I suddenly went, that's what I'm supposed to be doing.
There were many things about West Side Story that made it be groundbreaking. Not just the music, which had so much of a symphonic influence in addition to Latin American and jazz, but also because it was a quantum leap in combining music and dance to tell a story and to actually move the story forward.
It was a way of amalgamating book, music, lyrics, and dance into one seamless whole, which is exactly what the musical theater had been striving for.
We used to be able to watch a musical and someone would come out and sing a song about Bill, but there was no Bill in the show, but it was okay because it was a swell song. But as audiences got more sophisticated, they really needed the story to be told. And I think Jerome Robbins made that happen because he danced in character.
Rodgers and Hammerstein really revolutionized the integrated musical and the fact that the music propels the story. But West Side Story pushed the subject matter further.
It brought realism of what was happening in America right now, as opposed to some fantasy in a world far beyond. It put gang violence on stage, front and center.
You started it.
Who jumped Baby John this afternoon?
Who jumped me the first day I moved here?
The major thing it did for me, well, first of all, it was my first show, so in a way it put me on the map. What I learned from Lenny and Arthur and Jerry was a huge amount, because they're artists. They weren't just theater folk, they're artists. Arthur's a playwright, Lenny is a composer of all kinds of music, and Jerry, his major work was ballets. So here you have three men who actually come from different disciplines, all making a musical. And I learned a huge amount from Arthur about structure, about dialogue, about scenes, about character. From Lenny, I learned a lot about being less square. And from Jerry, I learned something about constant invention. It's like playing tennis with a better tennis player. Your game gets better.
Once you do West Side Story, it does change your life in one aspect or another as a dancer. Mainly because it's the only show where a dancer can truly act.
We've never acted before, and you had to be somebody. And Jerry, he'd look at you and say, well, what was your father's name? What's your mother's name? Do you have any brothers and sisters? So he made us go home and make up a history for ourselves so that we would know something about this particular character that we could hold on to.
Who are you in the film became very important to how he directed us. My name was not original cast. It was a fellow I had a fight with when I was in Harlem. You know, we used to call him Loco, Crazy Louie.
This is Loco.
Mucho gusto.
Encantada.
You get sucked into these characters, and their body is their tool just to tell the story, not so much to say, look at me and look how good I am. It's strictly for the story.
Everything got changed. And so you had dancers who had to learn how to act, and you had actors who had some dancing experience who had to learn how to dance.
I like to be in America, okay by me in America, everything free in America.
For a small fee in America.
I was the only Puerto Rican kid in my class, so I kind of had to play Bernardo in the sixth grade play. And so I sat and we rented the movie and I watched it with my mom. And so to see that one of the musical numbers in what's the greatest musical of all time is about whether we get to stay in Puerto Rico or stay here. It was unbelievable. I mean, it was like they reached out of the screen and spoke to me.
The first time that my father heard Cuban music, he was on a composing vacation in Key West, which is so far south that you can pick up radio signals from Cuba. And he heard this Cuban music on the radio and he just went nuts. He fell madly in love with that music, and on the spot he started writing his own music with those influences in it.
Where he lived, I think, was in ballet music and dance music. You know, I think his orchestral music is, for the most part, absolutely sensational.
When West Side Story was first being created, the original idea was that it would be a story about Catholics and Jews in New York City coming into conflict over the Easter Passover holidays, and this idea just was not getting off the ground.
In the summer of 1955, in the Beverly Hills Hotel, Lenny was at the pool one afternoon, and Arthur Lawrence came to visit him. Arthur showed up with the LA Times, and the headline that day was "More Mayhem from Chicano Gangs."
And when he saw that article, it was like, ding, you know, the light bulb went off and he thought, oh, do you mean like Latin American music? You mean, wow, this I could write.
The average theater orchestra used a drummer. We used a drummer and a percussionist. We would go over to a store and rent tambourines or maracas or things that normally would not be used in the theater.
And music can make you do things that you know it's too difficult to do, but you just, it feels good, and you get into that rhythm.
The minute you hear it, your whole body wants to move and dance, which is certainly how my father felt about music. He himself was so in love with rhythm, and all his music has this essential propulsive quality that nobody can resist.
When you're a jet, you're a top cat in town. You're a gold medal kid with a heavyweight crown.
Kenneth Tynan, the British critic, said it was as if Puccini and Stravinsky took a roller coaster ride into the precincts of modern jazz.
We're drawing the line, so keep your noses hidden.
When you think about how West Side Story seems to represent the 1950s in urban, especially New York, environment in America, that's an amazing achievement. If that's all Leonard Bernstein ever did, he would be one of the great composers of the 20th century.
West Side Story now is far removed from the reality of gang violence today. But in its time, it was very unsettling to everyone.
When West Side Story premiered on Broadway in 1957, it was epical because no musical had ended with three dead bodies in all. The gangland aspect made it even darker than the original Shakespeare Romeo and Juliet.
There were a lot of people that walked out, and it was a subject matter that they, you know, didn't quite or didn't want to understand.
On the second night after it opened, to very mixed reviews, the show had been maybe on for maybe 3 minutes. I heard, excuse me, and I looked, and there was a guy in the middle of the second row from the back with his coat over his arm, making his way, and he got to the edge of the aisle, and I obviously was looking with some surprise. Caught my eye, and he said, "Don't ask." And I got the whole picture. This was a tired businessman. On his way home, he thought, "I'll stop by and see a musical." On comes six street gang members snapping their fingers and going into ballet steps. And I could see him saying, "Oh my God." And he went home. My guess is he went to the nearest bar and had martinis instead of a musical.
West Side Story, the musical, did not win a Tony for Best Musical. And I believe it lost to The Music Man. which is a great show, but my dad was a little chagrined.
A lot of the reviews said, oh, the music's very exciting, unfortunately you can't hum any of it. Nobody was really interested in this until the movie came out.
History-making is the word for the motion picture critics have acclaimed as a masterpiece.
The movie version changed everything. And I think there are two reasons for that. Maria, Tonight, these songs were getting into the American, you know, consciousness. Also, we had movies about gang warfare before there was a West Side Story. The movie-going public was ready, and also they knew the music.
Those songs became sort of inescapable after the movie was released. The world caught up to it.
Boy, boy, crazy boy, get cool, boy.
What Jerome Robbins did in that movie is he made dancing the language that everyone speaks. That, I think, had never really been done before. Robbins auditioned some 2,000 dancers, he said, before finding the cream of the crop that are in this movie.
I couldn't believe how he was able to put ballet steps into these gang members, and it came off as real masculine kids that were ready to fight and ready to bust out.
It gave permission for a new form to come out of it, obviously as witnessed in like music videos and all that, where you're telling stories through dance.
Especially the Michael Jackson videos. Michael Jackson had a particular obsession with West Side Story. And David Winters, one of the original Jets, both on Broadway and in the film, remembers being approached by Jackson at some point, and Jackson, all he wanted to talk about was West Side Story.
Real cool.
I think West Side Story broke down the door in terms of serious subject matter to make it to a musical.
You can draw a line from West Side Story to Rent, dramatically speaking.
Look at Stephen Sondheim's career. It's an exercise in expanding the terrain we can use musicals to discuss. And I think it starts with West Side Story.
Favorite performances of West Side Story are always in high schools. That's the correct age that everybody should be in West Side Story. And kids relate to West Side Story like, I just can't tell you.
I can see why they want to do West Side Story, partly because of its energy and because it's about young people. It is about, and it's got the energy of young people.
When I was in high school, I was in charge of the senior musical and I directed West Side Story. I think a lot of first generation kids, they speak Spanish at home, they have one life at home, and they have one life at school. And West Side Story allowed me to bridge that. It allowed me to bring my Puerto Rican culture into school.
I'm pretty proud to know that President Obama put West Side Story on his iPod that he gave to Queen Elizabeth as a present.
It was kind of a way of saying, you know, this is our pop culture, but you share it with us.
The fact that West Side Story is part of it is exactly right. West Side Story is an essential part of American culture now.
Guess what? I didn't know that till this minute. Did she abdicate? The idea of her with the little earbuds, I'm sorry, it's too funny. It's too funny.
Hold my hand and we're halfway there.
I think it is absolutely its own animal. I think it's literally unique. There have been certainly other shows where dance has been used to tell the story and to propel the characters and all that. But not any better than West Side Story, I think.
It's got under my skin. It's a language. It's a language which is really mutates with the generations. And they were looking to a reality and made that reality a magic.
It's a marvel, the way it is still so fresh and vibrant today. It is true that if someone wrote it yesterday, everybody would think, wow, this sounds really different and modern and exciting.
West Side Story will continue into the 21st century because our society needs it. We're taught hate. We're not taught love. Love is innate. And we still lose sight of love.
It is about young people being frustrated and not understood, so they take their anger out on other people. And so I would say that West Side Story is as, if not more, relevant today than ever before.
You know, this idea of saying we all can get along, well, that's just talk. But when music does it for us, when you hear that Lenny and Steve wrote a score that can be accepted by everybody, I think that in itself is a feat.
There's a place for us. I mean, we all want that to be true, no matter what country we're from. It will resonate in everyone's life.
We're reminded with West Side that ignorance is not bliss, that to understand someone else's culture is to understand another human being that can give you something that you never had before. You can even fall in love. This is all about hope, and we still need a lot of that.